Welcome to Digital Asset News, take a top stories in cryptocurrency digital assets and break them down to bite-sized pieces. Today, NASDAQ listed GreenPro Capital to set up Bitcoin fund using a $100 million loan. This is another example of institutions coming in, and the price of Bitcoin is about to explode also. And lastly, we're going to look at some regulatory issues. First up, 183 violations. U.S. government fines BitGo for allowing users to bypass sanctions with cryptocurrency. This could be why the PayPal BitGo acquisition fell through. And all this regulation has exchanges spooked because Bittrex just announced that XMR, Zcash, and Dash will be removed on Friday, January 15th at 1100 hours. So we're going to take a look at what is exactly going on. So we'll do all that, but let's take a look at what's in the market. So congratulations, everybody. We made it out of the worst, crappiest year I can remember on as recent memory as far as 2020. What a junk year. So hopefully, if 2021 is the inverse of 2020, this should be fantastic. I've always said that 2021 is the year for crypto and digital assets. It always goes in a four-year cycle. 2012, there was a halving. 2013, all-time high. 2014, you had a huge dip. 2015 was like a reset. 2016, you had a halving. 2017, all-time high. 2018, you had that huge dip. 2019 was a reset. 2020 was our halving year. 2021, if history repeats, should be all-time highs. So let's see what happens. I'm feeling pretty good. Bitcoin up 29,000. So didn't hit that $30,000 mark. And you know, good old John McAfee lost that bet. Let's see if he is a man of his word and does what he says he's going to do. Ethereum is down 1.6%, but hey, it's still around 727 and 18% for the week, so I'll take it. Tether's Tether, nobody cares. Just kidding, somebody cares, and I'll tell you who it is. There's been a lot of discussion about Tether, if it really is pegged to the dollar one-to-one, if they actually have it in reserves, if that audit was actually justifiable, and what's going on. A lot of people were talking about how if Tether goes down, crypto goes down. I did a video yesterday which talked about how and why and exactly precisely that Celsius is a security. It's a registered security with the SEC. You can see the listing in the video I talked about. And we talk about Tether, about what could potentially happen. And in my opinion, it's not going to be registered as a security. The big question is the audit that went through, was it justifiable? And how many audits are actually going to happen? So that's one of those things. XRP, 23 cents. Watch out. Wow, it's up 7.8%. So congratulations all you XRP holders. Let's see how it all works out. Litecoin, 0.4%. Polkadot down 1%. But Polkadot was, it just flipped with Litecoin yesterday. And now they've flipped again. But it's up magnificently at 60% up. And we're going to go about why that is. Bitcoin Cash, Binance Coin, Cardano down 2%. It always hovers around 16 to 18 cents. Let's see if they can actually get past 20. Chainlink is in the top 10 and not too bad. What else we got? Anything fantastic? OKB. OKB, great. Theta Network is in the top 20. Not only is it in the top 20, it actually flipped Celsius Network, which not too long ago got in the top 20 itself. Celsius and Theta have been on a tear. I mean, look at that, 78% in a week. 43% you know, for Celsius. And if you've noticed, I get excited about certain projects. It's because I've invested into them and I am you know, biased, so that's just how it goes. What else we got? Nothing really good. Let's take a look at how you would have done if you just would have invested into Bitcoin. So I'm gonna flip this over to Bitcoin. XRP would have done fantastic, 7%. 0.1 for Binance Coin, 4% for Chainlink, that's pretty good. Again, OKB. Theta Network, 15%, 4%, 0, 13. So yeah, on some of these, you can definitely beat out Bitcoin. But the question is, which one is it and which one's going to be do the most magnificent? I don't know. I will just tell you this is I just want to go for the smart choice. And right now, with what's going on, I'm going to go Bitcoin Ethereum. And that's the majority. I'm actually DCAing 5 right now. You can watch the video on that. But Bitcoin, I think, is one of the ones that'll do pretty well. So is Ethereum. All right, let's look at today's top story. So first up, NASDAQ listed GreenPro Capital to set up Bitcoin fund using a $100 million loan. Jeez, that's pretty good. So this is just another example of institutions coming in and what are their choices? Really, it's Bitcoin. Ethereum a little bit here and there, but mostly Bitcoin. So GreenPro Capital, headquartered in Hong Kong, joins the growing list of banks, hedge funds, insurance companies, and institutions holding Bitcoin. And in a recent statement, they said this: "We believe the strategic management of our balance sheet combined with the implementation of our Bitcoin fund and crypto strategy will produce significant future value for the company." CEO C.K. Lee has already instructed Green Pro's investment bankers to raise debt in Q1, which is right now, up to $100 million to invest in Bitcoin. Green Pro Capital says it also believes that other top cryptos, such as Ethereum, will provide the opportunity for better returns and preserve the value of our capital over time rather than holding cash. I think, of course, Bitcoin is a great one for store of value. I'm not so sure about the currency narrative. However, I was thinking about this this morning because I was thinking about PayPal, how they're going to start to offer people to pay with their cryptocurrency for all their vendors, all their 300 plus million vendors. And of course, you can use all four of them. You can use Bitcoin, Bitcoin Cash, Ethereum, and Litecoin. And what they're going to do is they're not going to do that on chain. They're just going to sell it all in dollars and do their own, you know, thing behind the scenes. So it's really just like using paper Bitcoin. I think when people start to do that, I mean, it's a kind of a weird thing. You are using fiat. Yes, you are, for all these exchanges, but in a weird, perverted way, you are using Bitcoin by name only. So I think when people do this, they're like, wow, Bitcoin's super fast. I can't believe it's this quick. And really, it will be a currency. I mean, in people's eyes, don't know what the heck's going on. So it's just kind of weird way to think about it, but it's kind of like, yeah, you are using it as a currency, but not really. And in all honesty, I don't think people are really going to care. They're going to be like, wow, I can use this new currency. I can buy it as a currency and it goes up in value. My dollars don't do that, so I'm just going to use this cryptocurrency. Anyhow, for what's going on here with Green Pro, there are now 29 such companies. And what they're talking about here is the strategic management of our balance sheet provides significant future value for the company. What they're doing is looking at this, the 29 companies they're talking about, and they're taking a look at like places like MicroStrategy and Square, and they're going, wow, these guys put $1 billion in and they got $2 billion out. And that was in like 4 or 5 months. So we want that. Galaxy Digital, same $134,472,000. Of course, there's a little bit longer. You got Square, which I always think it's weird that Square, Jack Dorsey's the CEO and he's super bullish on Bitcoin and they put in $50 million and they doubled it. So I just think to myself, why don't they just increase that amount of money that they actually put in? Why wouldn't they just say, hey, we doubled our money in like almost no time. Let's keep doing that. But it hasn't happened. It's weird. Voyager, I mean, those guys made out like a bandit. They put in $8 million and they 4X'd. And then of course you have it all around these, you know, it breaks up by publicly traded companies, private, and then ETF like, you know, Grayscale and CoinShares and stuff like that. But this is what's interesting. All these 29 companies, if you add up all the Bitcoin they have, this is kind of scary. It's 1.1 million. 1.1 million. Right now, they say that there's 18.5 million in circulation. That's not true. We've lost, I think, at least 2 million. So really, it's 16.5 million. And these guys have like just 29 companies have 1 million of those. So when we talk about decentralization, I mean, is it? I mean, is it? I mean, it is. I mean, there's like, you know, 10,000 nodes across the world. So yeah, I get that. But I mean, it is in the hands of a very small amount of people. And that's one of the things that scares me. So it's just one of those things. I think it's going to help for the price of Bitcoin to stabilize as time goes on. But again, only time will tell. Not too sure. And then, I mean, we've just seen how great Bitcoin has been over the last, 365 days. The last year, 2020, crappy year, but it wasn't for Bitcoin. It's pretty good. And this was a nice little tweet that I found out from Messari. They put this little snippet and they said this. They go, look, here's the change in the market value of all the asset classes. And you can just take a look. I mean, every single year, it's like the same thing. Bitcoin, 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 Bitcoin. And then people still bash it. Like all these gold bugs, like sucks, it's made out of air, it's not going to work. And here we are every single year. I'm like, how many times do you have to just get your face ripped off and go, yeah, it's not awesome. And gold's going to, I'm just lost. It's like reality doesn't exist in some places. And you just have to look at numbers. Numbers don't lie. Here we are. I'm not saying you shouldn't buy gold. I buy gold. But I'm just saying, if you're going to buy gold, you might as well buy Bitcoin. So all the gold bugs out there are like, it's gold, 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 gold. Really, what they should be doing, they should be buying both. And they should be comparing it every year. I mean, what's the charm of putting a 5 to 10% in? And actually, I got this from one of my subscribers. He said, hey, I had this big heated discussion with this boomer about Bitcoin versus gold. And I was just like, why even argue? Just say, hey, boomer, let's just do this. Just buy a little Bitcoin and I'll buy a little bit of gold and we'll be in each other's world. And let's see how we do at the end of the year. I'm pretty sure We'll both be up, but the real question will be by how much? And that's all I got to say. I mean, don't, it's like fighting people with cryptocurrency. Like, why even fight them? Why just like, you know what? Sure. I'll buy it. And then we'll see what happens in a year. And then, you know, go from there. That's all I can say. I mean, really, there's no reason to fight about, you know, whatever. If you're going to make 28% a year, great. Of course, you could have made more in Bitcoin, then maybe some people will come around. It's a lot easier just to step in someone else's world and give them a little bit of a footing and then bring them back in to engage in the conversation. Like with certain people in crypto products, I'm like, I don't want to fight. I got too much shit to do. So let's just, if whatever you want to do, sure, I'll hold some of it. Let's just go that route. And then off we go. Same thing with gold and Bitcoin. So that's just what I got. Let me know what you think in the comment section. Let's move on. Regulations. This is crazy. I've always said in this channel that I believe we do need regulation, but we need a little bit of regulation. It's kind of like speed limits. I'm okay with speed limits. I mean, I don't want anybody zipping around at 200 miles per hour in their Tesla or whatever, however fast they can go. But if you're going to make everybody go 5 miles per hour on the highway, no one's going to get anything done. So this is a prime example. 183 violations. U.S. government fines BitGo for allowing users to bypass sanctions with crypto. So this is how things get a little crazy and how it all starts. The U.S. Department of the Treasury announced on Wednesday that the Office of Foreign Assets Control, or OFAC, has entered into a $98,000 settlement with BitGo, really $100K, just remember about $100K, for 183 violations of multiple sanctions programs. Doesn't that sound awful? Wow, 183 violations. Just keep that in mind, those two numbers, $100K and 183 violations. This is the statement. BitGo failed to prevent persons apparently located in the Crimea region of Ukraine, Cuba, Iran, Sudan, and Syria from using its non-custodial secure digital wallet management service. BitGo had reason to know that these users were located in sanctioned places because of the IP address, whatever. And then it says the 183 cryptocurrency transactions BitGo processed totaled under $10,000, $9,127. So these 183 transactions, which were under $10,000, and they took place between March 10th, 2015 and December 11th, 2019, that is the 183 violations. And it could have been some as like $10, but they all add up to 183 transactions, less than $10,000. And that's why they got fined for $100,000. So they 10x'd it for whatever it was. Well, okay, it was 9,000, but this is how much we're going to charge you, 100K. That's insane. And that's where we're at. So BitGo implemented an OFAC sanctions compliance policy after learning about its apparent violations in early 2020. So BitGo goes, okay, we get it. You're going to fine us, whatever. I'm sure they're going to be okay, right? A small company might be out of business, but BitGo's going to be okay. They're going to, you know, make these provisions, which included hiring a chief compliance officer and implementing a new OFAC policy, which now applies to all of BitGo's services. So what they did is that they're doing now is BitGo screens all accounts, including hot wallet accounts, against OFAC's specially designated nationals and blocked persons list, including blocked crypto wallet addressed and identified by OFAC. BitGo has also conducted a retro batch screen of all users. And like I was talking about in the beginning, because of what just happened, this is a very small community, this financial community, as far as big players. Trust me, I mean, I've been learning about it from the inside. And I can guarantee PayPal knew exactly what was going on with OFAC. They were probably like, oh, they're going to get busted. We don't know how much. We're just going to step away. And I think that's part of the reason, not the only reason, but part of the reason why this acquisition fell through. I thought it'd been great because, you know, then PayPal could be even deeper into cryptocurrency, probably also offer other cryptocurrency type of digital assets, maybe the ones that you are holding right now. So they would have skyrocketed in price. But because the government sticking their fat face into it and going, you know what, we're going to charge you with all these things, here we are. That's just a theory. And don't take it with a grain of salt. I could be 100% wrong, but I gotta believe that this might have had a little factor to play into it. And then on top of that, we also got news that Bittrex is going to be removing, I would say this is delisting, of Monero, Zcash, and Dash. And they're all going to go away on January 15th. And they knew what was going to happen. So you see this little comment here? I can't comment. Who can reply? People at Bittrex Exchange mentioned can reply, and that's it. I'm sure if they turn on the comment section, it would have been pretty disastrous for them. So not disastrous, but just kind of not nice. So that's what's going on. Again, I think regulation should be in place a little bit. I don't believe in total chaos. I believe that a little bit can go a long way. Just like eating a slice of cake, it's okay to slice. Just if you eat the whole shebang, it'll probably screw up your whole night. And that's where we're at. All right, so that's it for today. No, a little bit longer. If anything really comes up, I'll be putting out some information in a bit, but that is all. So thanks for listening throughout the whole thing. I really appreciate it. If you like those types of videos, I mean, Tumor is going to pop up on your left and right. I'll let PayPal make that magic happen, and that is all. So again, I think 2021 is our year. I just, with all the regulation coming down, it's going to be the year of two things. It's going to be the year of Bitcoin and institutions, and it's going to be the year of regulations. That's my philosophy. And we'll see how it all goes. So thanks again, and I'll see you on the next one.